Sahil, we're getting reports from Axios that Bannon may return to a lead editorial position at Breitbart News, known as an alt-right publication, and that he would basically become a, quote, that he has a, quote, killing machine in Breitbart News and is prepared to wage, quote, war. Also, there is a tweet from our own Kevin Cirilli saying, from a source close to Bannon, saying Democrats have seized control of the White House. Kelly, H.R., Gary, Jared, and Ivanka are all Democrats. How does Bannon's ouster change President Trump's support with his traditional base in the alt-right?
A few things, a number of really good questions here. So, number one, I don't think this has a meaningful impact necessarily on President Trump's support with sort of the nationalist, nativist base. Remember, the president had that campaign apparatus pretty much in place. He had that message where, you know, which largely revolved around stoking grievances over trade, over immigration, over so-called global elites who, you know, this base of people thought were harming them and holding them down. That doesn't necessarily change. Of course, there'll be questions asked by people in that base as to whether Trump's firing Bannon, as it seems to be, signals a shift on his part away from that. It doesn't seem likely to me that it necessarily reflects a major shift in the president's ideological thinking.
And so have we gotten any indications that there will be a policy shift, or as you say, or is this more just an execution shift or a methodology shift?
It seems more like the latter. And unless we have evidence that there is a policy shift or a shift in the thinking of this administration, or even a move to, you know, make things more disciplined and focused, which certainly the White House has not been, I would not assume that another personnel departure after many high-profile personnel departures in the White House necessarily means a shift in the ideological thinking. Now, you mentioned a moment ago that Bannon might be, according to reports, returning to his old home at Breitbart. This is a very significant potential development, because Bannon is arguably very dangerous to the White House from the outside. Breitbart is an influential publication with Trump's base of supporters. It was pretty supportive of him, and openly so during the campaign, during the Republican presidential primary, and very much so during the general election. And this has sort of been a source of power for President Trump. It's hard to know right now what exactly Bannon is thinking and what he'll do, but I just saw in Breitbart moments ago an article comparing President Trump to potentially the next Arnold Schwarzenegger, which is certainly, for their view, not a favorable comparison. So this will definitely be something to watch.